Swahili commanding words, imperatives. Hi all, welcome again to this channel. Today's lesson is Swahili commanding or imperative words, where we will be looking at them as a command in plural, and we will also learn its negative forms through short phrases. Karibuni sana. We are going to look at Swahili imperative words or commanding words in a chart form where we'll have three columns. One column will be for the command words in Swahili, the second one will be in English, and the third one will be the plural form of it. When imperative words are changed to plural, the last vowel changes to any, and, or any. So this is something you need to keep in your mind in order to remember how to work with these commanding words or imperatives. In this video, we'll also look at the negative form of the Swahili imperatives. And here, the Swahili commanding words are seen. The first column is the Swahili command word. The middle column is the translation of the command word in English. And the last one, you have the plural form of the command. So number one, you have kimbia. Kimbia means run. And in plural, we'll say kimbieni. Lima is also a command word, and the English meaning is dig, and Swahili plural form is limeni. We have a verb kula as a command word, meaning eat, and for plural or for many people, we can say kuleni. Funga, close. Fungeni is the plural of funga. Fanya means do. Fanyeni is the plural form of it. Soma means read, and in plural form it is someni. Endelea is go ahead in English, and endeleeni is the plural form of endelea. Njoo means come, and for plural, the word njooni is used. Leta means bring, and we can see here the Swahili plural form of it is leteni. The last one on this slide, we have rudi. Rudi means go back, and when you want to say it in plural form, you may say rudini from the word rudi. Now, ondoka is leave, ondokeni is the plural of it. Ongea means speak, ongeeni is the plural form of ongea. Cheza means play, chezeni is the plural of cheza. Kaa is sit, and the plural form, the commanding word for and plural is kaeni. Nunua means buy. Nunueni is the message sent to more than one person. It is the plural form of nenda. Of nunueni. Amka is wake up. Amkeni is the plural of amka. Ruka means jump. And when you want to address it as a plural form, you say amkeni. Ruka is jump, and plural is rukeni. We have the word furahi for enjoy. It changes to furahini as a plural form. Lala means sleep, and laleni is plural. Jibu is to answer or reply, and the plural form is jibuni. We have angalia. Angalia means look. And from the word angalia, we have angalieni as a plural form. From simama, which means stop, we have simameni, also a plural form. Kunywa is drink, and kunyweni is for plural. Andika means write, and keni is a command to more than one person. Jaribu is try, and jaribuni is the plural form of jaribu. Nenda means go, and you can say it nendeni when you are addressing as a plural form. Cheka means laugh, and chekeni is the plural, like you are telling people more than one person to laugh. Pumzika is rest, and pumzikeni is the plural form of pumzika from the Swahili command word. And we have sema. Sema is say. Say in plural is semeni. Piga is beat, and pigeni is the plural. After seeing a number of Swahili imperative or commanding words, now we are going to look at negations of Swahili commanding words. After seeing a number of these imperative and commanding words, now we are going to look at negations, which always have an infix C. As we know or we remember, C denotes the negative form of a Swahili sentence. So from the Swahili phrase kunywa soda, which can be translated as drink soda, the negative form of it is msinywe soda. Haraka is haria, msifanye haraka is the plural of fanya haraka. Sema kwa sauti, say it loud. Msiseme kwa sauti is the negative form. Angalieni pundamilia, look at the zebra. And the negative form is msiangalie pundamilia. From angalieni pundamilia to msiangalie pundamilia. Ondoka hapa means leave here. And the negative form is msiondoke hapa. Ongea naye means talk to him or her in English. And to form it a negative from ongea naye, we get usiongee naye. Then we have another Swahili phrase, njooni haraka, meaning come fast. Come fast, njooni haraka, when you want to put it in a negative, you say msije haraka. Msije haraka means don't come fast. Now we have more words here. Andika barua, meaning write a letter. And this is just a reminder that a negative form of a Swahili phrase, it always have infix C. C is a negative. Andika barua means write a letter. When you want to put it in a negative form, you can say usiandike barua. Kula mboga or kula mboga mboga means eat vegetables. Usile mboga is a negative. Kula and usile. Sema kwa sauti, say it loud. Sema kwa sauti means say it loud, and the negative form of it is msiseme kwa sauti. Msiseme is from the affirmative sema. Sema usiseme. So, ongea Kiingereza. Talk in English. Usiongee Kiingereza. Ongea Kiingereza is affirmative of a Swahili phrase, and the negative form, or a command, and the negative form is usiongee Kiingereza. Anza sasa means start now. Usianze sasa means don't start now. Chemsha maji, boil water. usichemshe maji is a negative and it means don't boil water. Kaini hapa is another command word, Swahili word, which can be translated as sit here. And the negative form is msikae hapa. Kaeni msikae. Now we have come to questions of the day, and we have three exercises for translating command words to Swahili. Number one, write don't shout in Swahili. Number two, go home now in Swahili. And number three, come here. Translate all these to Swahili. And that is the end of today's lesson. Let us meet again on the next video where we'll be learning more about Swahili. Thank you.